We are going to start module 4 of chapter 3. In this module, we are interested to apply Lagrangian method in solving some physical problems. So far, we have discussed the reformulation of Newtonian mechanics, which is commonly known as Lagrangian formalism. Lagrange's equations of motion for different types have been discussed in detail. Now we are interested to apply such equations in solving some physical problems. In this module, we shall discuss about the applications of Lagrange's equations of motion. So far, we have obtained Lagrange's equations of motion in different types of dynamical system, particularly in case of holonomic dynamical system and non-holonomic dynamical system. Let us apply those equations to solve some problems. Later on, using Lagrange's equations of motion, we shall obtain the solutions for some physical problems. First of all, consider example 1. Find the Lagrange's equation of motion of a simple pendulum. The sketch of the simple pendulum has been given in figure 3.1. Here, P is the position of the bob of the pendulum whose mass is m. The length of the string of the pendulum is L, which is fixed length. Theta is the angular displacement of the bob at this position from its vertical position. The height of the bob from the horizontal is h. This is the h. Here, PM is drawn perpendicular to the vertical position of the simple pendulum. The simple pendulum forms a dynamical system which is of holonomic nature. As in this case, the constraint relation satisfies the equation R square equal to L square, where R is the position vector of the bob at any time t, L is the fixed length of the string of the pendulum. It is independent of velocity, so it forms a holonomic dynamical system containing single particle, which is the bob of the pendulum. Let us calculate the kinetic energy of the simple pendulum. Kinetic energy is denoted by capital T, which is defined as half into mass into velocity square. Here, the bob has only the cross radial velocity. Since the radial velocity is r dot, here r is equal to L, so r dot vanishes, whereas cross radial velocity is r into theta dot, which gives L into theta dot as r equal to L. So the cross radial velocity is the only non-zero velocity of simple pendulum. Thus, kinetic energy T is given by half into m into square of the cross radial velocity, which gives L square into theta dot square. M is the mass of the ball. Let us calculate the potential energy of the bob. It is denoted by capital V, which is m into small g into h. G is the acceleration due to gravity. h is the height. Let us calculate h. From the figure we get h equal to l minus om. Om is given by l in cos theta. From the triangle we get the value of om. Substituting h, we get v equal to mg into l into 1 minus cos theta. It is already mentioned that simple pendulum forms a holonomic dynamical system. So, in this case, Lagrangian is the difference between the kinetic energy and potential energy. So, L equal to T minus V. If we substitute the expressions for T and V already obtained, then we get the explicit form of the Lagrangian L, which is written here. Here, theta is the only generalized coordinate. So, Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to theta coordinate is given by d dt of del L del theta dot minus del L del theta equal to 0. Here L is the Lagrangian, theta is the only generalized coordinate, theta dot is the generalized velocity, t is the time. If we calculate del L del theta, we get minus m g L sin theta, and del L del theta dot gives m L square theta dot. Substituting here and taking the ordinary derivative with respect to time t, we get m L square theta double dot plus m g L sin theta equal to 0. This can be written as m l square theta double dot equal to minus m g l into sin theta. We have only just shifted this term on the right hand side and get this equation. Dividing this equation by m l square, we get the next equation written here. If the angular displacement of the bulb, which is theta, is very small, then sin theta is nearly equal to theta. Substituting here, we get theta double dot is nearly equal to minus g divided by L into theta. This indicates that the pendulum executes simple harmonic motion. Here g is the acceleration due to gravity, L is the fixed length of the string, so the ratio is a constant quantity which is positive, so negative sign retains. This is the required equation of motion for the simple pendulum. Let us calculate the time period. Time period is given by 2 pi into root over L divided by g. We have already mentioned that g is the acceleration due to gravity. Consider the second example. For a dynamical system, Lagrangian is given by this equation, where capital A, B and C are functions of x, y and z. So that Lagrange's equations of motion are x double dot plus y dot into del capital A del y minus del capital B del x plus z dot into del capital A del z minus del capital C del x plus del capital V del x equal to 0 and two similar equations. Here x dot means dx dt, x double dot means d2x dt2. From the expression of Lagrangian, we find that there are three generalized coordinates which are x, y and z. So, we have three Lagrange's equations of motion. First of all, consider the Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to x coordinate, which is d dt of del l del x dot minus del l del x equal to 0. Calculating the partial derivative of L with respect to x dot and the partial derivative of L with respect to x separately and substituting here, we get this equation. Taking the time derivative of first term, that is time derivative of x dot plus capital A, we get the first two terms of the next equation, that is x double dot plus dA dt. These terms come from here, that is from del L del x. Let us calculate dA dt. Here A is a function of small x, y and z. So, dA dt is equal to del del x of capital A into x dot plus del del y of capital A into y dot plus del del z of capital A into z dot. Here we have used the chain rule of differentiation. Since A depends on x, y and z and x, y, z are functions of time t, x dot means dx dt. Substituting this expression here, we get this equation. Please note that this term, that is del A del x into x dot, cancels with the same term here. Arranging the similar terms, we get this equation. Similarly, considering the Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to y and z coordinates separately, we can get two other Lagrange's equations of motion. Let us consider the next example. Obtain the Lagrangian and also the Lagrange's equation of motion of a harmonic oscillator. A harmonic oscillator consists a single particle. Let the particle is of mass m. From figure 3.2, one can find that this is the position of the particle having mass m, whose distance from the fixed point O is x. Capital F is the force acting on the particle, which is directed towards the fixed point O. Here, the dynamical system is of 1 degree of freedom, since we are considering a system containing single particle. The only generalized coordinate is x. Let us calculate the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is denoted by capital T, which is half into mass into square of its velocity. So, T is equal to half into m into x dot square. Let us calculate the potential energy. Potential energy is denoted by capital V, which is half k into x square. Here, k is a constant. Since simple harmonic oscillator forms a dynamical system in which Lagrangian can be written as the difference between the kinetic energy and potential energy, so we have capital L equal to T minus capital V. Substituting the expressions for kinetic energy and potential energy, we get the right hand side portion. Here, x is the only generalized coordinate. So, the corresponding Lagrange's equation is given by ddt of del L del x dot minus del L del x equal to 0. Calculating del L del x and del L del x dot and substituting here, we get m x double dot plus k x equal to 0. Del L del x can be found from this term, which gives minus k into x. Here we have another negative sign, so we get positive sign here. Del L del x dot gives m into x dot. We are taking the time derivative, which gives m into x double dot. This equation can be rewritten as x double dot equal to minus k divided by m into x. Here k is a constant, m is another constant, both are positive. So, we find that the particle executes simple harmonic motion. This is the corresponding Lagrange's equation of motion for a simple harmonic oscillator. Let us consider next example. Find the Lagrangian of motion of a particle of unit mass moving in a central force field under a force that varies inversely as the square of the distance from the center O. From figure 3.3, you can find the sketch of the physical problem. O is the origin, OX is the initial line, P, R theta be the position of the particle in a central force field at any time t. This is the angular displacement theta. This is OP gives the positional coordinate R. It is given that the particle is under a force which varies inversely as the square of the distance. That is, F is proportional to 1 by R square. Since in a central force field, the force is always directed towards the center of force, that is O. So, we have the force as mu divided by R square. Mu is the constant of proportionality. Here we have two generalized coordinates, which are R and theta. Naturally, we can get two equations, that is, we can get two Lagrange's equations of motion. Let capital V be the potential, which have the following relation. minus DDR operated on capital V is equal to the corresponding force, which is capital F. F is given by minus mu divided by R square. Since the force is always directed towards the center of force, so we have the negative sign here. The negative signs cancels each other. Therefore, integrating we get V equal to minus mu divided by R plus constant of integration. Let us calculate the kinetic energy of the particle. Kinetic energy is denoted by capital T, which is equal to half into 1 into square of the velocity. Here we have considered a particle of unit mass, that is why m equal to 1. The velocity of the particle is r dot, which is the radial velocity. Its cross radial velocity is r into theta dot. So t is equal to half into r dot square plus r square into theta dot square. For this system, L is the difference between the kinetic energy and potential energy. L is the Lagrangian of this system. Substituting the expression for kinetic energy and potential energy, we get the expression for capital L. Now, Lagrange's equations of motion corresponding to generalized coordinate q e are ddt of del del q e dot operated on L minus del del q e operated on L equal to 0. Here we have two generalized coordinates, so E varies from 1 and 2. Q 1 equal to R, Q 2 equal to theta. First of all, consider the Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to the first generalized coordinate, that is R, which is ddt of del L del R dot minus del L del R equal to 0. Substituting del L del R dot and del L del R, we get this equation. Thus, we finally have R double dot minus R theta dot square plus mu divided by R square equal to 0. R double dot means second order ordinary derivative of R with respect to time t. Theta dot means first order ordinary derivative of theta with respect to time t. This is the Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to R coordinate. Let us obtain Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to theta coordinate, which is ddt of del L del theta dot minus del L del theta equal to 0. Substituting del L del theta dot and del L del theta, we get this equation. Please note that as L is independent of theta, so del L del theta vanishes. That is why we get only the first term. Substituting del L del theta dot, we get this one, which on integration gives R square theta dot equal to constant. Consider the next example. Obtain the Lagrange's equations of motion for a spherical pendulum. Spherical pendulum is a simple pendulum which can move throughout the space about the point of suspension. Its bob lies on the surface of a sphere whose length is equal to the length of the string. The sketch of the physical problem has been given in figure 3.4. P L comma theta comma phi be the position of the bob at any time t having mass m. PM is drawn perpendicular to the vertical position of the pendulum. Its height from the horizontal is small h. L is the length of the string of the pendulum which is fixed. Theta and phi have been shown here. This indicates the horizontal. Here r equal to l which is fixed. So, we have only two generalized coordinates which are theta and phi. Let us calculate kinetic energy, which is capital T equal to half into m into square of l into theta dot plus square of l into sin theta into phi dot. On simplification, we get the this portion. Potential energy is V equal to mg into h. H is given by L minus L into cos pi minus theta, which finally gives mg into L into 1 plus cos theta. So, L, which is the difference between the kinetic energy and potential energy, has this form. Now, Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to coordinate theta is given by ddt of del L del theta dot minus del L del theta equal to 0. Substituting the value of these partial derivatives, we get this equation. This is the Lagrange's equation of motion corresponding to theta coordinate. In a similar fashion, we can obtain the corresponding Lagrange's equation of motion for phi coordinate. As L is independent of phi, so del L del phi equal to 0. Thus, we have del L del phi dot equal to constant, which is given by m into L square sin square theta into phi dot equal to constant. Phi dot can be obtained as k divided by m into L square into sin square theta. So far, we have discussed different types of Lagrange's equations of motion applicable to holonomic system, non-holonomic system, system containing dissipative forces and many others. In this module, we have applied Lagrange's equations of motion to solve some physical problems. This provides us a much fresher way compared to Newtonian mechanics in solving some physical problems.